Even if you're not very big on investing, chances are you have at least put away some money in a PPF account to save tax. If nothing else, that's a good way to start. But if you haven't done that yet, you're really missing out. You're watching Why Not Mint Money, and I'm Nilanjana from Mint's personal finance team. Today, we're going to talk about the PPF account. Next to fixed deposits, small savings schemes are the most well-trusted go-to investment options for most Indians. And even among these, PPF or the Public Provident Fund account is probably the most popular. PPF is a social security scheme offered by the central government, and it's one of the small savings schemes made available through both post offices and some banks like SBI. PPF accounts mature in 15 years, and the rate of interest is determined by the central government quarterly. At present, the rate is 7.9%, which is better than what most banks offer for long-term fixed deposits. The minimum amount you need to deposit in a PPF account is only Rs. 500. You can deposit up to 1.5 lakh in a financial year. But the main benefit of a PPF is that it has the exempt status, which means that it offers the exemption on deposits of up to 1.5 lakh, as well as tax-free interests and returns under Section 80C of the Income Tax Act. In fact, since the exemption that can be availed of under Section 80C is up to 1.5 lakh, making a yearly deposit of that amount in your PPF account will ensure that you make the most of the exemption. This can also make it a little simpler for you to file your tax return. Anyone who is an Indian citizen is eligible to open a PPF account. In fact, you can even open one in the name of a minor. To open a PPF account, you have to visit a local post office or the nearest branch of one of the banks that is authorized to offer them. You will need identity proof, that is, your voter ID or PAN or an Aadhaar card, a proof of residence and passport size photos. You can get the application form and the nomination form at the bank and post office itself. Fill up the form and submit it with the KYC documents as well as the passport size photos and the minimum deposit of Rs. 500. Once all the documents are submitted with the initial deposit, you will be given a passbook for the PPF account. It will be complete with details like your name, your account number and the name of the branch where you open the account. Most banks allow you to open an operator PPF account online, which makes things a lot easier. In most cases, you're required to have a savings account with the bank in question in order to be eligible, and your KYC has to be up to date. If you have net banking enabled, you can simply log into the account and authorize the opening of a PPF account. Some banks might allow you to fill up the form online, but require you to submit a physical copy at the branch to complete the process. But keep in mind that this will only work if your bank is one of the authorized entities. If not, there is always the old-fashioned way. Once you have opened your account, make sure to make the minimum deposit of Rs. 500 each year. If you miss making the deposit for a year, the account will become dormant. While you can't claim tax exemption on a dormant account, it will still earn you interest till the maturity. To revive your dormant account, you will need to pay Rs. 500 for each of the years that the account remained inactive, as well as an additional fee of Rs. 50 for each year. PPF is a secure investment with a relatively high interest rate. But keep in mind that the interest rate is determined by the government and revised quarterly, which means that it can come down at any time. That said, it's a great way to save systematically while saving tax at the same time. That's all for now from us at Why Not Mint Money. You keep watching for more.